The Mulathen Pavilion, the site for women's semifinal hockey action. In this one, it is China taking on Russia. China was 2-1 in round-robin play with wins over the United States and Spain, while Russia was 2-0 as they defeated Kazakhstan and Canada. There you see the Russians in their traditional red, white, and blue, and then China with the unique pink jerseys and the red pants and red helmet. Russia are the defending silver medalists, having lost to Canada back in 2013 in Trentino. China has one silver medal, which they earned from women's hockey in Harbin in 2009. Starting goaltender for Russia, it'll be Yulia Leskina, a 9.56 save percentage and a 0.92 goals against average. And for China, it'll be Yukin Wang, a 9.37 save percentage and a 2.46 goals against average. She plays her club hockey in Harbin. Russia gets going early, just over 3 minutes into it. Goncharenko with the slap shot on the setup from Olga Shoshina. And there you see the one-timer. It goes clear in past Wong. 19 seconds later, it'll be Iya Gavrilova with that snapshot, top shelf. That's her tournament-leading fifth goal, putting Russia up 2-0. And just over a couple minutes after that, Russia gets their third. That's a wrister from Shokina. And after that, China would swap goaltenders with Yang coming in for Wang. Another slap shot there from the point eludes the Chinese keeper. That is Goncharenko with a one-timer from Shoshina and Shokina. So after the first period of play, it was 4-0 Russia. Almost 6 minutes in, there'll be a scramble in front of the net. You can see it here. Both teams fighting for the puck, and ultimately it gets banged in by a Chinese player. That's Zhao, who puts it past her own goal line. Bulatova will get credit for it. Russia up 5-0. Russia will go ahead 6-0 here. On the power play, Angelina Goncharenko with her third of the tournament. That's Russia's seventh power play goal. And they lead the tournament operating at 50% with the player advantage. So China would again swap their goaltenders. Wang now comes back into the game. And there you see the replay on that one timer. Same time, Russia would swap goaltenders too as Morozova comes in for Leskina. As the second period winds down, Belyakova allowed to walk right in, and she'll bank that one home on the backhand. Now 7-0 in favor of Russia. Here you get a replay of it. Belyakova right in front, and just that deflection, but it still banks home, I think again off of Zhao's skate. Russia will clear the puck out late here in the second period. It creates a 2-on-1, and a great shot there. That's Shokina. Rifles that one home. Another assist for Olga Shoshina. She has 9 now in the tournament and leads the tournament in scoring with 12 points in 3 games. Get a great look at that slapper here, right up over the glove hand of Wong. 8-0 after the second period of play. Yang back into the game in net for China. And early here in the period, a breakaway. That is Shokina. Hat trick goal for her. She ties Gavrilova for the tournament lead with 5. 9-0. Russia in front. And we get a reverse angle view of that breakaway for Anna Shokina. Now we move late in the third period. Still 9-0. And a nice late pass there from Gavrilova to Belyakova. That's her second of the night. Russia's 10th. And they are into double digits. So Russia will skate away with an easy 10-0 victory here in the semifinal. Final shots on goal, 57-14 in favor of the Russians. Olga Shoshina with 5 assists in the hockey game. She now has 9 in the tournament, 12 points overall to lead all scorers. Anna Shokina with 3 goals and 1 assist. Belyakova with 2 goals and a helper. Russia will now move on to face Canada for gold on February 12th at 8:30 p.m. in Granada. They'll be looking to avenge their loss in the gold medal game to Canada back in Trentino in 2013.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.